Red Brick Media. High quality CDs, DVDs, lectures, khutbah, conferences and Quran recitations. All revenue generated supports our dawah work, supported by visiting our store. You can now purchase directly from our site, www.redbrickmedia.co.uk. غرباء 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 غرباء.
الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله.
الشيخ began by praising Allah Azza wa Jal and sending peace and salutations upon our Nabi and our Rasul.
إخواني النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قدوتنا وأسوة لنا في كل شيء.
Said brothers, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is an example for us and a model for us in everything.
قال الله عز وجل.
Allah said.
لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة.
Verily you have in the Messenger of Allah a perfect example.
لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر.
For the one who intends on meeting Allah and the last day.
وذكر الله كثيرا.
And he remembers Allah a lot.
وقال الله تبارك وتعالى.
And Allah mentioned as well.
قل إن كنتم تحبون الله.
Tell them if you truly love Allah.
فاتبعوني يحببكم الله.
Then follow me and Allah will love you.
ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم.
And he will forgive you for your sins.
والله غفور رحيم.
And Allah is غفور رحيم.
إخواني لا نظن بأن المتابعة للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقط في الصلاة والصيام.
Brothers, let us not think or understand that following the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is only dealing with following him in praying and fasting.
فليست المتابعة مقتصرة على العبادة.
But following him is not just connected to the issue of the forms of worship.
بل في كذلك كيف كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يعيش.
We also following him, meaning following him is also connected to the way he lived.
وكيف يتعامل مع الناس.
And how he used to deal with the people.
وكيف يتعامل مع الزوجات.
And how he dealt with his wives.
إخواني الدعاة.
Brother, those people who call to Islam, the du'at.
أو كثير من الدعات.
Or many of those who busy themselves with da'wah.
يظلمون زوجاتهم.
They oppress their wives
في طريقة التعامل.
In the way that they deal with them.
ويظن بأن الشدة في العبادة.
And they think that being stern upon worship.
أفضل من حسن معاملتي مع الزوجات.
Is better than the issue of being good with their wives or families.
بينما قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Although the prophet said.
خيركم خيركم لأهله.
The best of you is the best of you to his family.
وأنا خيركم لأهلي.
And I'm the best of you to my family.
وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And he also said.
أثقل شيء في الميزان يوم القيامة.
The heaviest thing in the scales on the day of judgment.
حسن الخلق.
Will be good character.
نريد أن نعيش لحظات أو ساعات مع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في بيته.
So we want to take this opportunity so that we can live some hours, some time with the Prophet in his house, صلى الله عليه وسلم.
مع زوجاته.
With his wives.
لنأخذ إخواني البند الأول أو النقطة الأولى حركات كان يبديها النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Let's take as a first point some of the things that he used to do in his movements.
لإبداء مشاعره نحو زوجته.
In order to show and express his feelings and emotions towards his wives.
لربما لو فعلها بعضنا.
To the point that some of us, if we were to do some of these things.
لظن بأن هذا الأمر مخالفا للرجولة.
Some people we would think that. Acting like this is against and in contradiction to the deen.
ويظن بأنها مخالفة للمروءة.
And also that is in contradiction of manliness, what it is to be a man.
ولكن أرجل الرجال.
But the real men, the strongest of the men.
وسيد المروءة كما يقال من الخلق.
And the master of manliness.
كان يفعل هذه الأمور ويبديها ويتحرك بها.
He صلى الله عليه وسلم used to do these things and his movements were incorporated in these issues.
من ذلك إخواني.
From that example.
أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Is that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
كان يضع فمه.
He used to put his mouth.
موضع فم أم المؤمنين عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها.
On the same place where our mother Aisha used to put her mouth.
من الإناء.
When she used to drink from the cup.
روى مسلم عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها.
الإمام مسلم narrated that our mother Aisha
قالت
she said
كنت أشرب وأنا حائض
I used to drink from the cup while I was on my menses
من إناء النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم
from the vessel of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم
فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يأخذ الإناء
and then the Prophet would take the glass from her
ويبحث عن موضع فم عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها
and he would intentionally look for the place where she put her mouth on the glass
تقول فيضع فاه
and she said he would put his mouth
على موضعي فيه
on the exact place where her mouth was
فيشرب.
and then he would drink
هذه الحالة الأولى.
This is the first condition we want to mention
وأتعرق العرق يأخذ العظم العظام الذي عليه اللحم
and also concerning the part of the meat the part of the animal that had most of the meat
فأكل منها
she would eat from it
فيأتي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم
and then the prophet would come after that
فيضع فاه موضع على موضع فيه
and he also would eat from the same portion of that food that meat that Aisha ate from
ما المانع أن يجلس الرجل مع زوجته
who from amongst us from the men here would sit with his wife
لحظة أثناء الطعام
for some time and he's sitting with his wife over a meal
فتشرب زوجته من الإناء
and then his wife drinks from a vessel
فيأخذ هذا الإناء
and then the man takes that vessel from her
وينظر إليها بابتسامة نظرة حب
and then he looks at his wife smiling and with a look of love and affection
فيبحث عن موضع فيها
and then in front of her he looks for the place where her mouth was
ثم يشرب من هذا الموضع
and then he himself drinks from the same exact place
ويحتسب الأجر في هذا
and then he'll get reward as a result of that
وتأكل هي من موضع من الإناء.
Another example is who from amongst us has his wife. She eats from a particular place from the food.
فيأتي ويدير هذا الإناء.
And then the man comes and he turns that meal, that plate around.
ويأكل من موضعها.
And then he also eats from the same place where she ate from.
لو أكلت من ملعقة.
If she ate from some morsels of the food.
فيأخذ لو أكلت بالملعقة.
If she ate with a spoon
فيأخذ ملعقتها
and then he takes her spoon
فيأكل في نفس هذه الملعقة
and then he eats from the same spoon that she ate from
لماذا لا نفعل هذا
why don't we do that
وسيد البشر قد فعل هذا
and the master of all of the human beings صلى الله عليه وسلم he used to do it
حركات لإبداء المشاعر
these are movements that show and express his emotions
لإظهار الحب
so that she can see the manifestation of his love
إن كان يصعب عليك أن تتلفظ بكلمات الحب
if it's difficult for one of us to express our love for our wives by saying it
فتحرك شيئا لإبداء هذه المشاعر
then at least do certain movements that will relay the same message concerning your emotions
والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كم عمره
and the prophet how old was he
هل هو في عمر المراهقة
was he a teenager
كان في الستينات وفي الخمسينات
he was in his 60s above the age of 50
ومع هذا يتصرف هذا التصرف
and despite that age look how he used to deal with his wives
ولماذا العشاق قبل الزواج
so the sheikh said for the months before the marriage
وربما بدون زواج
and even without getting married
وعلاقات محرمة
and the relationship is not the acceptable one
لو ذهب مع عشيقته
if a person went with his girlfriend
إلى المطعم أو إلى مكان يأكل
and to a place in order that they can eat a meal
فإنه يشرب من موضع شربها
if he would eat from the place or drink from the place of the glass
وينازعها الكأس
and then gave her the glass
بينما إذا تزوج
and they didn't even get married yet
يشعر بأنه مخالف للمروءة
this is something that done because it goes against the way of manliness
لماذا هذا التناقض
he said why do we have this conflict and contradiction
في العلاقات المباحة
in the relationships that are permissible
يحرم على نفسه هذه الحركات لإبداء المشاعر
a person makes it haram for him to express himself in these ways
ويمنع نفسه من الاقتداء بالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في مثل هذه الأحوال
and he prevents himself from being like the prophet and getting the war for being like the prophet in these issues
بينما في العلاقات المحرمة
but then when it comes to the relationships that are not acceptable
يظهر هذا الحب وهذا العشق
these examples and these expressions are put there
مثال آخر للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم
another example of the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم
عندما رجع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من خيبر
is that when he returned from the place that is known as Khaybar
قد تزوج من صفية
and he had married our mother Sophia
فعندما أرادت أن تركب على الناقة
when he wanted or she wanted to ride on the camel,
ماذا فعل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم?
What did the prophet do for her?
وضع فخذه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم على الأرض.
He صلى الله عليه وسلم put his knee on the ground.
فقال لصفية رضي الله تعالى عنها.
And then he said to Sophia,
اركبي.
Get on, ride, get on it.
أي ضعي رجلك على فخذي.
Meaning, step on my thigh so as to get up.
فركبت صفية رضي الله تعالى.
So she did that and she was able to ride the camel.
هل يفعل أحدنا هذا مع زوجته?
Will one of us, does any of us do this with our wives?
ربما بعضهم يفعل لكن العدد قليل.
Maybe there are some people who do it, but the minority, they are the people of the minority.
لماذا لا نتصرف هذه التصرفات مع زوجاتنا?
Why don't we behave like this and respond like this with our wives?
أخوان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم
the prophet also صلى الله عليه وسلم
في كل أوقاته يظهر هذه المشاعر
and all of the times and every opportunity he used to express himself like this
في الأحوال الطبيعية
in the times and the natural times
ليس فقط لحظة المعاشرة
not just the times when he's with his wife
ليس فقط لحظة المعاشرة لحظة الجماع
He wouldn't just be like this at the times when he's going to have physical, sexual relationships with his wife.
في كل الأوقات.
But all of the time he was like this.
كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يظهر هذه المشاعر.
He used to express and manifest these feelings and emotions.
أضرب لكم الأمثلة على هذا.
I give you some examples on this.
النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لحظة الصيام.
He صلى الله عليه وسلم when he was fasting.
وهو صائم.
And he was fasting.
وجالس مع زوجته.
He was sitting with his wife.
جلسة طبيعية.
Just the regular, normal, natural sitting.
ليس جلسة جماع.
It wasn't the sitting where they were going to have physical or sexual relationships.
فأتي إلى زوجته ويقبلها.
He came to her in this condition while he was fasting and he kissed her.
ثم يجلس معها ويحادثها.
And then he sat with her and he was talking to her, communicating with her.
روى الترمذي.
الإمام الترمذي narrated.
أنه روى عن إحدى زوجات النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
That one al-Imam al-Tirmidhi collected a hadith in which one of the wives of the Prophet said
إنها قالت قبل رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وهو صائم
The Prophet kissed me while he was fasting
بل هذا الآن كما يقال لحظة وهو صائم
and he did this while he was fasting
إذا أراد أن يخرج قبلها كذلك
and also if he wanted to leave the house he would also give her a kiss
إلى أين يريد أن يذهب يريد أن يسافر
if he wanted to travel
لا يريد أن يخرج إلى الصلاة.
He said no. He didn't give a kiss because he wanted to travel. That's why he kissed her. But he was on his way to the masjid to pray.
إذا أراد أن يخرج إلى الصلاة قبل زوجته.
And if he returned from the salat, went in the house, he kissed his wife.
روى الإمام أحمد.
الإمام أحمد narrated.
عن عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها.
عائشة, may Allah be pleased with her.
أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قبل بعض نسائه.
That the Prophet kissed some of his wives.
ثم خرج إلى المصلى.
And then he went out to the prayer.
ولم يتوضأ.
And he didn't make wudu after kissing her.
هل يفعل أحدنا هذا مع زوجته?
Does anyone from amongst us do that with his wife?
كلما أراد أن يذهب إلى الصلاة قبل زوجته ثم خرج.
Every time he leaves and he wants to go to the salat, he kisses his wife.
هذا حوال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
This is the condition of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
قبل الخروج يقبل.
Before he went out, he would kiss her.
وإذا جلس يقبل.
And if he sat with her, he would kiss her.
أي في دخوله وخروجه يقبل زوجته.
So when he came in, when he went out, he would kiss his wife.
لماذا?
Why is that?
حركات لإظهار المشاعر.
These are the movements that he showed in order to share and to show and display his affection.
أم المؤمنين رضي الله تعالى عنها لما كبرت بعد وفاة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The mother of the believers after the death of the prophet when she became older.
وكان قد تزوج ابن أخيها.
And her nephew had gotten married.
وهو القاسم بن محمد بن أبي بكر.
And he is Qasim. The son of her brother Muhammad was the son of Abu Bakr.
فعندما تزوج حديثا
when that boy became a newlywed and he got married
وزوجته جميلة
and his wife was beautiful
فدخل على أم المؤمنين على عمته
the boy his her nephew Aisha's nephew came into the presence of Aisha.
فجلس معها مع زوجته
so Aisha sat with the boy Qasim and his newly wed wife
فقالت له
and she said to him
قبل زوجتك
kiss your wife
فاستحي
so he was shy
قالت قبل زوجتك
she said kiss your wife
لما أراد أن تعلم حياة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Why did she do that? She wanted to teach the boy the way the prophet was and the way his lifestyle was.
والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Brothers, the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
أحيانا يباشر زوجته وهو لا يريد الجماع.
Sometimes he used to be physical with his wife, deal with his wife, but he didn't want to have a relationship.
الذي يدل على هذا.
The thing that proves this point.
حديث مسلم.
Is the hadith that's been collected by Imam Muslim.
أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
That he صلى الله عليه وسلم.
كان يباشر نساءه.
He used to physically be physical with his wives.
وهي حائض.
While she was on her menses.
لا يريد الجماع.
So that's a clear proof he didn't want to have a relationship.
ولكن لإظهار الحب والمودة.
But he did this in order to manifest his affection towards her and his love.
أخوان من حركات لإظهار المشاعر.
So these types of shows of affection.
وأظن هذا من أندر النوادر أن يفعلها الإنسان أو من أندر النادر أن يفعلها الداعية.
And the Sheikh said this is an issue showing these affections. They are from the things that they're very seldom amongst people who are giving dawah to Allah.
وإن كان واحد منا يفعلها لو يكتب رسالة ولا يكتب اسمه يقول أنا أفعلها.
There are some people who may do it. And they're the minority. Not even have the people who write a letter just to say how he feels.
وما أظن أن أحد يفعل.
He said, but we don't have many people who do that.
وأنا أود لو كتب أحد وقول وقال أنا أفعلها مع زوجتي.
He said he wished and he would love that someone would at least write. Someone wouldn't be shy to write yes and say I do that with my wife.
ما هو الشيء.
He said it's not the case.
روى البخاري ومسلم.
الإمام البخاري ومسلم collected or narrated the hadith.
عن عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها.
And Aisha, she said.
قالت.
She said.
كنت أغتسل أنا ورسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
I used to take the ghusl or the bath along with the Prophet together, صلى الله عليه وسلم.
من إناء بيني وبينه.
From the same vessel that we would share between ourselves.
تختلف أيدينا عليه على هذا الإناء في أخذ الماء.
Our hands would ultimately go inside of the water to get the water.
فيبادرني يأخذ قبلي.
So he would take the water before me.
حتى أقول دعلي يا رسول الله.
To the point where I would say to him, leave some water for me. Let me have some too.
ومع ذلك يحصل هذا التنازع.
And this conflict.
وليس تنازع بغض وإنما تنازع حب.
This conflict that used to happen concerning the water, him taking first, her taking, saying, leaving for me, is not a conflict of negativity and hatred. It's a conflict of love and affection.
كم عدد الدعاة الذين يغتسلون مع زوجاتهم في نفس الوقت وفي نفس المكان؟
The Sheikh said, how many people give dawah to Allah? How many of them are there who actually take a ghusl along with their wife at the same time?
ويتلاعبان في لحظة الاغتسال.
And they, while taking the water, they're playing and jesting with one another in this way.
ربما نسمع عن العشاق.
The Sheikh said, maybe we hear about like girlfriends and boyfriends.
الذي بينهما علاقات محرمة.
That they have this relationship between themselves.
ولكن من النادر أن يحدث هذا بين الدعاة وبين زوجاتهم.
They may do it, but people who are actually married, it's very seldom that they will show these forms of affection between themselves.
وأن هذه الحركات مؤثرة جدا على الزوجة.
The Sheikh said, brothers, these types of actions and movements, they affect the wife.
المرأة عاطفية.
The woman is emotional.
الكلمة الصغيرة تؤثر عليها.
And the small word will have an impact upon.
لماذا تسمع دائما من الأوامر فقط؟ افعلي لما لم تفعل.
So why is it that all the time the wife, all she hears from us, the word, the small word, it affects her. So all she hears from us is orders, commands, do this, don't do this, do this, don't do that.
لماذا المحاسبة الدائمة؟
So why is it that we're always taking her to account?
أما إبداء المشاعر فالرجل شحيح في إبداء المشاعر.
As for these shows of affection, many times you'll find the man is stingy in regards to this.
النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم حتى في الاسم يدلع كما يقال ويدلل زوجته باسمها.
Even when it comes to the name of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he used to spoil his wife concerning her name.
اسمه عائش يقول عائشة يقول يا عائش.
Her name is Aisha, but he would say to her, hey عائش.
يتلاعب باسمها.
And he would play around by changing the name.
وجهها أحمر هي حمراء.
Her face was white, was red. And he would say and call her, hey, you little red one, you red lady. So this shows us that the man has to spoil his wife even with her name. And when it comes to expressing yourself in these emotions, it's permissible for a man to lie to his wife in order to express these shows of affection. Not lie in order to get something that's impermissible, but in regards to showing affection. And some of the people, they say that this type of show of affection, it is like a type of trickery.
كيف?
How is that?
مثل لو أتت إليك زوجتك بهدية.
For an example, if your wife were to come to you with a gift,
بعطر.
Like some perfume.
فقالت لك قد اشتريت لك هذا العطر.
And she said to you, I brought for you this perfume.
لو كان هذا العطر سيء.
If the smell of the perfume was not nice.
ورائحته ليست جيدة.
And the way it looked wasn't nice, and the smell of it wasn't nice.
أظن أغلبنا.
I think that the majority of us.
يقول ما هذا هذه رائحة.
We'll say what is this smell.
بينما لو قال لها.
But if on the other hand he were to say to her.
ما شاء الله. ما هذه الرائحة.
ما شاء الله. What is this smell?
لم أجد مثلها.
I have never found anything similar to it.
وهو في الحقيقة لم يجد مثلها في السوق كما يقال.
And he says that I've never seen that this is being sold in the marketplace.
لكنه لم يقل لها في السوق. يقول لم أجد مثلها.
He said, he repeats that I didn't even find similar to this.
لو طهت له طعاما.
If she were to feed him some food.
وطعمه غير مقبول.
And it was not the type of food that's acceptable to the taste.
تقول ما رأيك بهذا الطعم؟ قطعته لك الآن.
She says to him, "What's your opinion about this food? I made it for you just now."
يقول ما شاء الله ما هذا الطهي.
He says, "MashaAllah, this is really good food, delicious."
لم أذق يوما مثل هذا الطعم.
I've never eaten any food like this food from today.
وفعلا هو لم يذق مثل هذا الطعام.
And it is true that he never ate or tasted like that food.
إخواني الأمر مو مقتصر فقط بين الزوج.
He said, إخواني, this issue is not an issue of the two spouses disagreeing or agreeing.
بل كذلك الزوجة.
But also this is an issue in regards to the wife.
وغالبا الأزواج لا يحسنون الاختيار.
And many of the wives, they're not good at choosing.
فيأتي بثوب إلى الزوجة.
So the man, many men, they're not good in choosing things. So I'll give you an example. The man, he brings a thobe, he chose for his wife, he brings it to her.
غالب النساء,
most of the women,
ماذا يقولن للزوج?
What do they criticize concerning
ما شاء
husband?
الله, كيف اخترت هذا الثوب?
If the husband brought to the wife a thobe, she would say that, MashaAllah, this is something that's nice.
وهي تقصد لم ترى مثل هذا الثوب في القبح كذلك.
And she also never saw a thobe that was like this ugly before, but she said those words.
فالأمر لا يقتصر فقط على الرجال في قول بل كذلك على النساء.
So the fact that this lying is permissible, it's not something that is exclusive to men, it's also something permissible for the women as well.
ولذا روى مسلم عن أم كلثوم.
And for that reason, Imam Muslim, he collected the hadith that أم كلثوم
بنت عقبة,
she is the daughter of Uqba,
قالت,
she said,
لم يرخص في الكذب,
lying was not made permissible or allowed,
إلا في ثلاث,
except in three circumstances.
الرجل يحدث امرأته,
when a man speaks to his wife,
أي في هذا,
and he lies to her.
والمرأة تحدث زوجها.
And also the lady speaks to the husband and lies to him.
أي هذا الكذب مسموح فيه.
So this type of lying is permissible.
وكذلك الإصلاح بين الاثنين.
And also it's permissible to lie when you're going to make peace between two warring factions.
بين الاثنين صديقين أو
between
أخوين.
Two friends, two brothers.
والحالة الثالثة في الحرب. الحرب خدعة.
And the third condition when lying is permissible is in the state of war.
إخواني كذلك أمر ثالث في حياة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم مع زوجاته.
So the third point we want to bring to your attention concerning the way the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to deal with his wives.
المزاح والملاعبة.
Is that he used to have a sense of humor and he used to joke and play with them.
النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم
he صلى الله عليه وسلم
حتى في الحرب وفي الجهاد
even when there was a war when there was jihad
كان يلاعب زوجاته
he used to joke and play with his wife
خرج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في سفر
one day he traveled went on a journey
تقول أم المؤمنين رضي الله عنها عائشة
our mother Aisha said
وكنت في ذاك الوقت لم أحمل اللحم أي كنت ضعيفة كنت يعني لم أكن سمينة
She said during this journey during that time when it happened I hadn't put on weight at that time
فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الجيش تقدم
So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told the members of the army the party you people go forward go ahead
فطالب منها المسابقة
And he said to Aisha when they were together I challenge you to a race
تقول فسبقته
So they raced and Aisha, she beat the Prophet in the race.
ثم مرت الأيام.
And then the days passed by.
تقول بعد ما حملت اللحم.
She said, after I put on weight.
فخرج مرة أخرى في الجهاد.
We went out and the Prophet was on a journey of jihad.
فقال للجيش تقدم.
And I was with him and he said to the army, you people go ahead of us.
قال فسابقين.
She said, let's have this race again.
قالت يا رسول الله قد حملت اللحم.
She said, يا رسول الله, I've put on so much weight now.
قال السابقين.
He said, let's race.
قالت فسابقته.
So therefore she said they raced one another.
فسبقني.
And this time the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم beat me in the race.
فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And then he said to her,
هذه بتلك.
This race that I won is repaying you for the one that we did before in which you won. This is a payback. So the question is, which one from amongst us would race his wife?
هل تابعنا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في هذا?
Did the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم refrain from doing such a thing?
ألم يكن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لنا أسوة?
Isn't he for us an example?
أخوان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من معاملته لزوجاته.
From the way he used to deal with his wives.
أنه كان يتحمل لأجلها.
He used to have patience and he used to persevere on her behalf.
في يوم من الأيام عندما أتى الأحباش مبايعين للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
One day, a group of Ethiopians came in the presence of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وقد أسلموا.
And they had embraced Islam.
ووافق هذا يوم عيد.
And when they came, it happened to be the day of the Eid.
ففي المسجد النبوي.
In the Prophet's Masjid,
أخذوا يرقصون رقصة الأحباش.
They started to do the dance of the Ethiopians.
والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم حجرته ملاصقة للمسجد.
And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, his households, his inner apartments were connected to the Masjid.
ونافذتها على المسجد.
And
نافذة.
The windows of the house they led inside. You can see inside of the masjid from the windows of the house.
أخذ النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ينظر إليهم.
So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was looking at those Ethiopians.
وعائشة رضي الله عنها قد اتكأت خلف النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And Aisha she leaned up against him from behind him.
تقول وضعت وجهي على عاتق النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
She said that she put her face on the shoulder of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وخدي على خده.
And her cheek on his cheek.
وأخذت تنظر إليه.
And she was watching those Ethiopians in the masjid doing their dance.
تقول تعب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من الوقوف.
And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم became tired from watching.
فأخذ يراوح بين رجليه ويحرك رجليه.
So while he was in that condition and she was watching, he started to move around, started to become uncomfortable.
ويقول هل اكتفيتي؟
And she would say to her, did you get enough? Did you get enough?
تقول لا يا رسول الله.
She would say, no, I want to keep watching.
قالت وما في حب النظر إلى هذه الرقصة.
She said, and I didn't care about looking at those people.
ولكن ليعلم الصحابة.
I just wanted to let all of the companions know.
كيف يعامل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم زوجاته؟
How the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم dealt with his wives.
ليعاملهم زوجاته.
So that they, the men from the companions, can also do the same actions with their wives.
في يوم العيد دخل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم البيت.
One day on the day of the Eid, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم went inside of his house.
وعائشة صغيرة في السن.
And Aisha was a young girl.
ومعها صويحباتها.
And with her were some of her young friends.
وهن يضربن بالدف في يوم العيد.
And they were hitting and playing the duf on the day of the Eid.
فدخل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وغطى وجهه.
He entered in there into them. And he covered up his face.
لئلا تستحي لئلا يستحين من النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. لئلا يخجلن من النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. فيخرج.
So that the girls wouldn't become shy and embarrassed of him coming in, and then as a result of that, they would exit the house.
لذلك غطى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وجهه لئلا يخرجن.
So for that reason, the Prophet covered his face so as not to frighten them.
فاستلقى على الفراش وقد غطى وجهه.
So he laid down the bed, and he covered up his face.
فأتى أبو بكر رضي الله عنه.
And then Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, he came to the house.
فقال.
He said.
أمزمار الشيطان في بيت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Do we have the flutes of the shaitan in the house of the Messenger of Allah?
وهذا يدل بأن أبا بكر قد علم بأن المعازف محرمة.
And that's a delil that Abu Bakr knew that the ma'azif, the musical instruments are haram. That statement lets us know he knows it's haram.
فماذا قال له النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم؟
What did the Prophet say when he heard that?
قال دعهم يا أبا بكر.
He said, Abu Bakr, leave these girls.
فإن لكل قوم عيد.
For every group of people, they have a day of celebration, an Eid.
وهذا عيدنا.
And this is the Eid of ours.
أي فقط مسموح لهم بالدف في المناسبات كالعيد.
Meaning, this is the day for this celebration that it is allowed for the girls to hit and to beat the duf.
وهذا حديث رواه البخاري.
This hadith is in Sahih al-Bukhari.
حالة الخامسة للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Fifth situation with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and his wives.
كيف يلبس الزوج لزوجته؟
So the fifth situation is going to talk about how does the husband dress for his wife.
الرجل منا عندما يأتي إلى زوجته.
One of the people from amongst us, a man, whenever he goes to his wife,
يقول لها ما هذه الثياب.
He says, well, what are these? What is this robe?
لماذا لم تتزيني لي?
You say to your wife when you go to, why didn't you beautify yourself for me?
غالبنا يسأل زوجته بهذه الطريقة.
Most of us, this is how we ask our wives.
لماذا لم تشتري ثيابا وتتزيني لي?
Why didn't you, lady, buy a thobe or some clothes to beautify yourself for me?
بينما هو لا يلبس شيئا لا يتزين له.
Whereas he himself, he never ever dresses in any particular way for her.
يلبس ثيابا بالية.
He wears the clothes that are just regular and normal.
ويريد أن يتقرب ويريد أن يقترب منها.
And he wants to get close to her.
بينما يحاسبها على لباسها.
And at the same time, he accuses her and he holds her account for not beautifying herself for him.
الله عز وجل قال.
Allah said in the Quran.
ولهن.
And for those women.
مثل الذي عليهن.
They have the same rights that are over them.
وللرجال عليهن درجة.
And the men have levels over those women.
ماذا يقول ابن عباس رضي الله عنه?
What did Abdullah ibn Abbas say?
إني أحب.
He said, I love.
أن أتزين لزوجتي.
To beautify myself for my wife.
كما أحب أن تتزين لي.
The same way that I want her to beautify herself for me.
قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The Prophet said.
خيركم خيركم لأهله.
The best of you is the best of you to his family.
وأنا خيركم لأهله.
And I'm the best of you to my family.
أخوان رجل منا يظن بأن التجمل والتزين فقط من واجبات الزوجة.
Some of us think that beautifying yourselves and looking nice is from what is only exclusively for the wife.
وليس من حقوق الزوجة، ليس من واجبات الزوج.
And it's not from what is wajib upon him.
يجلس في المنزل.
He sits in his house.
وربما لحظة المعاشرة.
And when he's going to have sexual relationships,
يطلب من أهله.
He requests from his wife.
أن تلبس له اللباس الفاضح.
To wear a particular type of clothes.
لكنه هو لا يلبس لها مثل هذا اللباس.
But he himself, he won't wear those kind of clothes.
لماذا?
Why? Why doesn't he do it?
إخوان لماذا العشاق يلبسون لبعضهم والعلاقات محرمة يلبسون لبعضهم مثل هذا اللبس؟
So brothers, why is it that the girlfriends, the boyfriends between themselves, they are not reluctant to wear these type of clothes?
بينما الرجال الأزواج العلاقات كما يقال مباحة لا يلبس لها مثل هذا اللباس.
Whereas the husbands and the wives in their relationship, they themselves don't dress up like that for one another.
ربما يأتيها بلباس بال أثناء الجماع.
Maybe he'll come to her when he wants to have relationships with her with clothes that are not appropriate.
روى البخاري عن امرأة ثابت بن قيس.
الإمام البخاري narrated that the woman, the wife of ثابت بن قيس.
قالت امرأة ثابت بن قيس يا رسول الله.
She came and she say, "Oh Messenger of Allah."
قالت ثابت بن قيس لا أعتب عليه في خلق.
She said, "My husband ثابت بن قيس, I have no complaints about him concerning his character.
ولا أعتب عليه في دين.
Nor do I complain about his religion.
ولكني أكره الكفر في الإسلام.
But I hate and I dislike disbelief after coming into Islam. Okay. How? What does that mean?
قالت رأيته بين أصحابه.
She said I saw him with his friends, his companions.
فاستقبحته.
And when I saw him, I just didn't like him.
لماذا?
Why?
لم يتزين لم يظهر زينته لم يظهر جماله.
Because he didn't beautify himself, he didn't come out and look in the way he wasn't representing. She said, I saw him with those people, his friends, and I just disliked
them.
So I'm afraid that if we don't get this divorce, I'm going to be compelled to disbelieve
حتى يفرق بيننا.
So that then I can get my freedom from him.
ثم أرجع إلى الإسلام بعد.
And then I'll come back to Islam after disbelieving.
فقالت أكره الكفر في الإسلام.
So I hate to go into kufr after I became a Muslim.
فقال لها النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So the Prophet said to her.
أتردين عليه حديقته أي المهر الذي دفعه إليك.
The dowry that he gave you for the marriage, are you going to? You're willing to give it back to him?
قالت نعم.
She said yes.
ففرق فخلعها النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من زوجها.
So the Prophet granted her the khula from her husband.
لماذا؟
Why?
لم يتجمل لم يتزين.
The khula came as a result of the man not beautifying himself and appearing in a nice form to the lady.
يظن أحد بأن الجمال متعلق فقط بالنساء دون الرجال.
So some of us think that this issue of beautification is something that is connected to women and not to the men.
كثير من الشباب قبل الزواج
many of the youngsters before marriage
يتزينون
they beautify themselves
ويلبسون أفضل الثياب
and they wear the nicest robes, the nicest clothes
لا سيما في المواضع التي فيها النساء
especially in the places where there happen to be women
من أجل أن تلتفت إليه
in order for the women to look at him
فإن تزوج
but if he got married
ترك هذا التجمل
he stopped beautifying himself
عند الجماع لا يلتفت إلى أي نوع من أنواع الثياب
نعم
عند المعاشرة لا يلتفت إلى اختيار الثياب المناسبة.
Some people once they get married and gonna have relationships, they don't even consider men. They don't even consider the issue of how they look in their clothes.
عند الخروج
when he goes out
مع زوجته
with his wife
لا يتخير أفضل الثياب.
He doesn't choose the best of the clothes.
وإنما بقايا ثوب اليوم الذي بقي يلبسه.
But the thobe that he had on all day. That's the one that he keeps wearing when he goes out with her.
وإذا ذهب إلى العمل لبس أفضل الثياب.
But when he goes to work, he puts on the best clothes to go to work in.
وإذا ذهب إلى أصحابه لبس أفضل الثياب.
And if he goes to his friends, his companions, he wears the best clothes.
لكن مع زوجته يلبس بقايا الثياب.
But when he's with his wife, he goes out with his wife. He wears what is left over.
خيركم خيركم لأهله.
The best of you is the best of you to his family.
ولهن مثل الذي عليهن.
And those women, they have a right similar to the rights that are the men have over them.
التطيب إخواني.
So we have to have a tatayyib, be nice with them.
النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يكره أن توجد منه رائحة غير طيبة رائحة خبيثة.
So the next point, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he used to not like smells that were repugnant.
كان يحب الطيب.
He used to like perfumes.
في يوم الأيام,
one day,
كان بعض الناس قد أهدوا إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عسلا.
Some people gave to him as a gift some honey.
ولكن في بيت أي زوجة؟
But it was given to him, and he was in whose house from his wives?
عند صفية.
In the house of Sophia.
وكانت حجر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم متصلة ببعضها.
And his حجرات, his inner apartments in the house, in the masjid, they were connected one to another, the houses and the homes of his wives.
وكانت عائشة غيورة رضي الله عنها.
And Aisha, she became jealous.
فعندما دخل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم على صفية رضي الله عنها.
So when the Prophet went in and he went to visit Sophia.
فقدمت إليه عسلا.
She gave him some honey.
وكان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يحب العسل.
And he used to love honey.
فعندما دخل على صفية أخذ عائشة تنظر ماذا يفعل في بيت صفية.
So because the houses were close and he went in and he was with Sophia, Aisha was looking to see what is he doing with her.
فأخذ النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يأكل من العسل ويتلذذ به.
So she saw him eating the honey and enjoying the honey.
فغارت عائشة رضي الله عنها.
So she became jealous at this thing that she saw.
فدعت حفصة قالت تعال.
So she said to Hafsa, come here, come here.
وكانت زوجات النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قد قسمنا إلى حزبين.
And the wives of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, they were two groups, split into two groups.
حزب تقوده عائشة رضي الله عنها.
One group, they were supportive of Aisha.
وحزب تقوده أم سلمة.
One group that Aisha, she was controlling them. And the other group was the group that Umm Salama was controlling.
فعندما أخذ يأكل في بيت صفية
So when he began to eat in Sophia's house
دعت من مجموعتها حفصة قالت تعال
Aisha, she called those group women that were with her and from them was Hafsa, come here
قالت انظري ماذا يفعل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
She said, look at what he's doing over there.
وفي رواية دعت سودة كذلك.
نعم شيخ.
دعت سودة بنت زمعة.
So they also called Sauda bint Zam'a, the other wife.
قالت انظري إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And they kept saying, look, look what he's doing.
قالت إذا دخل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الآن علينا.
So they said, if he comes to us and enters in upon us.
نقول ما هذه الرائحة.
Let's say to him, this, what's this smell you have?
رائحة مغافير, رائحة ليست طيبة.
This is a smell that is not nice, repugnant smell.
ليكره النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الأكل من هذا العسل.
So that he won't ever eat that honey again in her house.
فعندما خرج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من صفية.
So when the prophet left the home of Sophia.
ذهبت حفصة إلى غرفتها.
Aisha, Hafsa went to her room.
فدخل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم مع عائشة.
And the prophet came to Aisha.
فعندما اقترب منها.
When he came close to Aisha.
قالت يا رسول الله ما هذه الرائحة.
She said, يا رسول الله, what is that smell?
قال ما هذه الرائحة.
He said, what smell?
قالت رائحة مغافير, رائحة غير طيبة.
Something that's coming from you is not nice, repugnant smell.
قال لم أفعل شيء, أكلت العسل, شربت العسل.
He said, I didn't do anything, but I did eat some honey. I had some honey.
فقالت هذا عسل غير طيب الظاهر.
She said, that honey, it does not smell good.
بعدما خرج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم منها.
So he left from Aisha.
دخل على حفصة.
And he went to Hafsa.
فقالت حفصة كما قالت عائشة, لقنتها عائشة ماذا تقول.
She said the same thing that Aisha said. Aisha convinced her to repeat the same words.
قالت نفس الكلمات.
And the Prophet ﷺ said to her the same thing he said to Aisha.
وفي رواية دخل على سودة فقالت له نفس هذه الكلمات.
And in another narration of the hadith it said that he entered upon Sauda and the same incident happened.
فحرم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم على نفسه العسل.
As a result of that, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he made it haram upon himself, he prohibited himself from eating honey.
فأنزل الله عز وجل قوله.
And then as a result of all of this, Allah عز وجل revealed the statements of the Quran.
يا أيها النبي.
O Nabi.
لم تحرم ما أحل الله لك.
Why do you make haram what Allah made halal for you?
تبتغي مرضات أزواجك.
That you were just trying to please your wives.
والله غفور رحيم.
And Allah is غفور رحيم.
ثم عاتب الله عز وجل عائشة وحفصة.
And then after that, Allah تعالى, he rebuked Aisha and Hafsa.
إن تتوبا إلى الله.
If you too make tawbah to Allah.
فقد صغت قلوبكما.
Verily your hearts would become pure.
وإن تظاهر عليه على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ضده.
And if you collectively go against him.
فإن الله هو مولاه.
For verily Allah is his protector.
وجبريل.
And Jibril is.
وصالح المؤمنين.
And all of the righteous believers.
والملائكة بعد ذلك ظهير.
And all of the malaika in addition to all of that are his helpers.
عسى الله إن طلقكن. عسى الله إن طلقكن.
It may be that. It may be that if he divorces you,
أن يبدله,
that Allah Ta'ala will make it apparent to him
أزواجا خيرا منكم,
some other to marry other women who are better than you.
فعاتبهم الله عز وجل عتابا شديدا.
So Allah rebuked them in this ayat, a very stern and strong rebuke.
الشاهد من هذا أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يكره أن توجد منه رائحة غير طيبة.
So the point of all of that is about the smells. The Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم didn't like for any bad smell to emanate from his person. Whereas some of us, if he came or comes to his wife, he has the smell of underarm odor. It's sour.
ثم يأتي ليجامع زوجته.
And in this condition, he comes to have relationships with his wife.
ويحاسبها لو لم تتطيب.
And he himself accuses her and holds her accountable if she doesn't beautify herself for him.
وهو رائحة خبيثة لا يمكن يجلس أحد معه.
He himself has a very bad smell that people cannot stand and live with him.
يأتي من لعب الكرة كما يقال.
He comes from playing football, soccer.
ويتصبب عرقا.
And he's dripping sweat.
ثم وعياذ بالله يأتي إلى زوجته ليهجم على زوجته.
And then the sheikh said after that in this condition and he said أعوذ بالله, he comes to have relationships with his wife.
وربما يدخن.
And maybe he's one of those who's a smoker.
ثم يقترب بفمه إلى فم زوجته.
And then he wants to put his lips, his mouth, the lips and the mouth of his wife.
رائحة خبيثة.
And it has that bad smell, bad odor.
فكيف يقبل أحدنا أن يأتي أهله هكذا؟
So, إخواني, how can one of us allow ourselves to come to his wife like that?
وإنما يذهب ويغتسل.
No, he has to do this, to go and he has to clean himself.
ويستخدم أفضل أنواع الصابون كما يقال.
And then use the nicest soaps.
ويتطيب.
And then he puts on nice perfume.
ويلبس اللباس المناسب للوضع الذي سيجالس أهله.
And he wears the appropriate clothes for that condition that he's going to sit with his wife in.
مثل الذي عليهم.
Because of the ayah that the women have rights similar to the rights that are over them.
لماذا الغرب تفوق علينا في مثل هذه الأمور؟
Why is it, إخواني, that the people they have superseded us men in this issue?
الحالة السادسة.
The sixth condition concerning the conditions of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and his wives.
إخواني اسمحوا لي أدخلت في مثل هذه الأمور.
الشيخ said, إخواني, this is an issue we need to pay attention to in these affairs.
ولذلك الذي هم بعيدون عن الزواج أو يعني صغار السن ربما بعض الأمور لا تصلح لهم.
The Sheikh said he does acknowledge that some people are not married, they're far away from getting married. Some of this may not be applicable to them.
ولكن أحببت أن أبين كيف حياة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
But what I want to do here is I want to explain to the vast majority of married people how the Prophet was with his wives.
حتى في المباشرة والجماع.
Even in regards to having sexual relationships with the family.
لو قرأنا كتاب الله عز وجل.
The Sheikh said, if we were to read the book of Allah,
أحوال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم,
and the condition of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم,
أحوال الصحابة رضي الله عنهم,
and how the companions were,
كيف حالهم في أثناء الجماع,
how they were during the time of having sexual relationships.
كثير من الرجال يقضي وطره من زوجته ثم يقوم.
Some men, they have relationships with their wives, sexual relationships with their wives, they get up and they go.
دون أن تصل هي إلى وطرها.
Without giving her an opportunity to reach her point of satisfaction.
هو يصل إلى مرحلة القمة لحظة المعاشرة بينما هي لم تصل إلى هذه المرحلة.
He himself, he reaches his climax, the apex, where she, in her case, she doesn't get that opportunity.
فيكون قد حرمها حقها.
So as a result of that, he has prevented her from her haq.
حتى في مقدمات الجماع.
Even in the issue of foreplay.
يريد أن يهجم مرة واحدة.
He wants to attack one time, just one time. Jump on it.
دون مقدمات.
Without any foreplay.
بينما النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قرأنا في أغلب أحواله كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يحسن التعامل مع أهله.
Whereas the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in most of his conditions he used to do a good job, he used to do a good job in what comes before having the physical relationship.
حتى في تنويع طريقة الجماع.
Even in the whole process, in the whole way of the way he performed the relationship with her.
يأتي أهله بطريقة واحدة.
He comes to his wife in one way.
بينما الله عز وجل فتح كل الطرق.
Although, like one of the people today, he comes to his wife the same way, all the time. But Allah Ta'ala in the Quran has explained the permissibility of multiple ways.
وحرم فقط طريقة واحدة.
And Allah made it haram one way.
وهو أن يأتي في دبره.
And that is for him to come to her in the anus.
وهذا يكون فعله كفعل قوم لوط.
And whoever does that, he's doing the action of the people of Lut. May Allah Ta'ala protect us from that.
أما لو أتى في القبول.
But if he came from the back, but in the right place.
سواء من الخلف أو من الأمام أو بأي طريقة من الطرق.
Whether it was from the back, whether it was from the front, or whatever other than that, but she went in the right place.
الله عز وجل قد أباح ذلك.
Allah Ta'ala has made that permissible.
قال نساؤكم حرث لكم.
Allah said in the Quran, your women are a tilth unto you.
فأتوا حرثكم أن شئتم.
So come to your tilth however you choose.
ما معنى أن شئتم؟
What is the meaning of however you choose?
في كل وقت شئتم.
In all, at all times that you want to.
وفي جميع الأوضاع ائتوهن كذلك.
And in all conditions you can come to them.
فيأتي من الأمام ومن الخلف ومن الجلوس ومن القيام جميع الطرق.
He could come from the front, from the back, standing up, sitting down, whatever. It's all of that permissible.
الذي يدل على هذا.
The thing that proves this point.
عموم الآية.
Is the generalization, the generality of the آية.
ثم في حديث عمر الخطاب رضي الله عنه.
And then we have the hadith of عمر رضي الله عنه.
قال أتيت إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
عمر said, I came to the messenger of Allah.
فقلت يا رسول الله.
And I said, oh messenger of Allah.
هلكت وأهلكت.
I have destroyed myself.
ماذا فعلت؟
The Rasul said, what did you do?
قال حولت رحلي.
He said, I turned my ride around.
أي أتيت أهلي من الخلف.
Meaning, he said that in a nice way. I turned my riding beast around. What he meant by that is, I had a relationship with my wife from the turning her around.
ولكن في الموضع المباح.
But in the right place, though.
قال فقال الله عز وجل.
The Prophet said, Allah said.
نعم. أنزل الله عز وجل قوله.
As a result of that, Allah revealed the ayat.
نساؤكم حرث لكم.
Your women are tilth unto you.
فأتوا حرثكم أن شئتم.
So come to your tilth how you choose.
ولكن الدبر قد حرمه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وحرمه الله عز وجل في قصة قومه.
But the anus, Allah Ta'ala has made it haram in the story of the people of Lut in the Quran, and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم has also made that impermissible.
ولذا ذكر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بأن الله عز وجل قد لعن.
And for that reason, our Nabi has explained to us that Allah Azza wa Jalla has cursed
من أتى امرأة في دبرها
the person who comes to the lady in her anus.
وبعد هذا الاتيان يذهب ويغتسل مع أهله.
And then after that, they have relationships. Let the man get up and let him go and have a ghusl, a bath with his wife.
فهكذا في لحظات المداعبة أو أعني لحظات الجماع والمعاشرة.
So this is how our Prophet was, صلى الله عليه وسلم, during the time of having physical relationships with his people.
ولكن عليه أن يمتنع من المحرمات اللا أخلاقية لحظات الجماع.
It's his responsibility though to avoid those things that are not permissible.
فبعضهم يطلب من زوجته.
Some people, they request from the wife certain things.
بعض الأمور التي لا يقبلها القلب ولا يقبلها العقل.
Some things that the intellect does not accept, and some things that the heart does not accept.
ولا تقبله الأخلاق.
And even the character, the good character, doesn't accept it.
فلا يجوز له أن يقدم عليها لحظة المعاشرة.
And in these conditions, it's not permissible for him to come to her during these times.
هذه طريقة سابعة من معاملة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لنسائه.
Point number 7 concerning how the Prophet used to deal with his wives.
هو إظهار تقدير الزوجة أمام الناس.
And it is what he used to do in trying to show the respect that he had for his wife in front of the people.
في يوم الأيام,
one day,
أتى رجل فارسي إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
A Persian man came to the Messenger of Allah.
فدعاه إلى الطعام.
So he invited him to have some food.
وكان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بقربه عائشة رضي الله عنها.
And Aisha was next to the Messenger of Allah.
قال وهذه أي معي إلى تأتي إلى الطعام معي مدعوة معي إلى الطعام.
And he was saying that she's going to be with me also with the food.
فقال الفارسي لا.
The Persian man said no.
فقال له رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
He said, then no, you can't come.
ثم أتى الفارسي مرة ثانية.
Then the man came back again.
فقال يا رسول الله دعوتك إلى الطعام.
Oh, the Persian man invited the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم to the food. And then the Prophet said, he's going to come to the food with Aisha. I'll come with Aisha. The man said, no, don't come. And then the man went away and he came back and he said, Ya Rasulullah, I invite you to the food before.
فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم هذه كذلك.
He said, okay, I'll come, but she's coming with me.
فقال الفارسي لا.
He said, no.
فقال له رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا إذا.
He said, then I'm not coming.
ثم ذهب فأتى مرة ثالثة.
Persian man came the third time.
فقال يا رسول الله.
He said, Ya Rasulullah.
دعاه إلى الطعام مرة ثالثة.
I'm asking you and inviting you to the food a third time.
ظهر فقال له النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم هذا.
He said again, what about her?
فأصر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عائشة
so
رضي الله عنها.
So he insisted that she comes.
إظهارا لحبه لها.
In order to express and to show his love for her.
فقال أجل يا رسول الله.
So the man said, okay.
فاستجاب لهذا الفارسي.
So he accepted the invitation of the Persian man.
إذن أظهر حبك لزوجتك حتى أمام الناس.
So إخواني, you should manifest and show the love that you have and the respect that you have for your wife in front of the people.
في يوم الأيام أتى عمر بن العاص إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
One day the companion Amr ibn al-As he came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وكان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا رآه تبسم في وجهه.
And any time he saw the Messenger of Allah and they saw each other, Rasul would smile in his face.
فظن بأنه أحب الناس إلى رسول الله.
As a result of that, he used to think that he was the most beloved person to the Prophet.
قال يا رسول الله.
He said to him, O Messenger of Allah,
من أحب الناس إليك؟
Who is the most beloved person to you?
فظن بأنه يقول عمر بن العاص.
He thought that the Prophet was going to say, you, Amr ibn al-As.
فقال عائشة رضي الله
He said Aisha is the most
important.
So this is an indication of how he showed his love to others for his wife.
وذكر اسمها.
And he also mentioned her name.
ولم يخجل من ذكر اسمها.
And he wasn't shy to mention her name.
فقال عمرو لا يا رسول الله من الرجال أسألك من الرجال.
He said, no, I don't mean about who you love the most from the women. I'm talking about the men. Who do you love the most?
ظن يقول عمرو بن العاص. ظن يقول عمرو بن العاص.
He thought that the prophet was going to say you, I love you the most.
فقال أبو بكر.
The prophet said, I love Abu Bakr the most.
قال ثم من؟
He said, and then after Abu Bakr.
يقول عمرو.
He thought he was going to say you, عمر.
قال عمر بن الخطاب.
He said, عمر بن الخطاب.
قال ثم من؟
He said, and then who?
فقال أبو عبيدة.
He said, أبو عبيدة.
He
said, okay, he left the thing and he went away.
الشاهد من هذا أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The point here, إخواني, is that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم
كان يظهر حبه لزوجاته أمام الناس وأمام الجميع.
He used to express and show and illustrate his love to the people for his wife.
ولم يخجل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من ذلك.
And he wasn't shy or embarrassed about that.
مسألة ثامنة.
The eighth point.
الانفراد بالزوجة.
Seclusion with the wife.
كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يختلي بزوجاته.
He صلى الله عليه وسلم used to pay attention to his wives.
حتى في السفر.
Even in the issue of traveling
في الجيش,
with the army,
ومع ذلك انفرد بزوجاته.
And even though he was in this group of people, he would be secluded. He would make time to seclude himself with his wife.
كما مرت علينا القصة في المسابقة.
Like the story that we've already explained, the race with Aisha.
لماذا لا تجعل لك يوما في الأسبوع في كل أسبوع؟
So why is it, إخواني, why don't one of us make a day from each week
لتنفرد بزوجتك,
so that it could just be you and your wife,
وتذهب معها,
and you go with her somewhere.
ربما تذهب معها وتشرب في الخارج.
Maybe you go somewhere and you drink outside.
أو تذهب إلى مطعم.
Or you go to a restaurant.
أو تذهب إلى مكان جميل تجلس فيه.
Or to a nice place where you guys can sit together.
تنادمك وتنادمها. تنادي تحدثها وتحدث في الكلام
الجميل. So that you can talk and communicate with one another.
ثم بعد ذلك ترجع ولو ساعتين ولو ثلاث ساعات.
And then after that come back even if it's only 1 hour, 2 hours, whatever.
لماذا تنفرد مع صاحبك الذي تحبه؟
Why is it that you spend time and you seclude yourself with your friend who you love?
ولا تنفرد مع زوجتك.
But you don't do that with your wife.
فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان ينفرد بزوجاته.
So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he used to take time out to seclude himself, spend time with his family.
وأني كنت أقرأ حديثا.
The Sheikh said that he used to read a hadith.
وكنت يعني لا أستطيع أن أفهم هذا الحديث.
And I found difficult. I couldn't understand and comprehend the hadith.
لا أستطيع أن أتصور هذا الحديث.
I couldn't visualize it. I couldn't comprehend it.
وهو حديث النسائي.
And it's a hadith in النسائي.
يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Where he said صلى الله عليه وسلم.
رحم الله رجلا.
May Allah have mercy upon the man.
قام من الليل. أي يصلي الليل.
He stood up to pray the night prayer.
فصلى.
And he prayed.
وأيقظ امرأته.
And he woke his family up.
فإن أبت.
And if she refused to get up.
نضح في وجهها الماء.
He would sprinkle water in her face.
ورحم الله امرأته.
And may Allah have mercy upon the lady.
قامت من الليل.
Who got up to pray during the night.
فصلت.
And she prayed.
وأيقظت زوجها.
And she woke up her husband.
فإن أبى.
And if he refuses to get up.
نضحت في وجهه.
She throws water and sprinkles water in his face.
كنت أقرأ هذا الحديث.
شيخ سلام, I used to read this hadith.
قلت ربما أقبل أنه أنضح في وجه زوجتي الماء.
He said, I can understand, I can comprehend the man sprinkling the water in the face of the lady.
لكن لم أستطع أن أتصور.
But I couldn't comprehend.
أن المرأة تجعل على زوجها الماء أو تنضح في وجه زوجها الماء وهو نائم.
Couldn't comprehend. The woman doing the same thing, sprinkling water in the face of the husband while he was sleeping.
فإنه يستشيط غضبا.
Because he's going to answer that by being angry with her.
يتحول النوم إلى مشاجرة بعد ذلك.
His sleep is going to turn into a big argument, a fight.
وربما يؤدي إلى الفراق.
And maybe it'll lead to separation.
فكيف يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم رحم الله امرأة فعلت.
So how can the prophet pray a dua of rahma on a lady who does this?
لكني لما قرأت سيرة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Sheikh said, but when I begin to read the history and the life of the Prophet.
في تعامله مع زوجاته.
And the way he was with his wives.
العلاقة علاقة حب.
And his relationship with them, connection was love.
وعلاقة مودة.
And affection.
دائما في كل أوقات.
In all times, at all times.
تصور رجلا صديقا تحبه.
Imagine your friend, a friend that you really love.
تحبه حبا شديدا.
You really love him.
ويحبك حبا شديدا.
And he also loves you.
ثم من الليل أيقظته.
And then at night time you woke him up.
ولم يقم من النوم.
And he didn't get up.
فأخذت تلاعبه.
And you start playing with him to get him up.
فرششت في وجهه الماء.
And you took the water and you sprinkled it in his face.
فاستيقظ يضحك معك وأخذ يلاعبه.
Then he wake up and he start laughing. You guys laugh together and you get up and pray.
هذا ممكن بين الصديقين.
He said this is something that happens between two friends.
ممكن وهذا رأيته بعيني.
He said yes, I saw that with my own eyes.
مع زوجتك أولى أن تكون هذه العلاقة.
He said. It's more that your relationship should be with your wife should be like this. The relationship of love, affection, and being connected, connection. The best of you is the best of you to his family.
وإذا قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And for that reason, the prophet said.
وإذا أيقظ الرجل امرأته.
And if a man wakes up his wife.
من الليل فصلي.
From the night. For the night prayer, and they pray together.
فصلي ركعتين.
They two of them pray two ركع.
كان تلك الليلة.
That night.
من الذاكرين الله كثيرا.
They will be from those who remember Allah a lot.
والذاكرات.
From the men and the women who remember Allah a lot.
ربما بقيت بعض الأمور لكن ربما إن شاء الله يعني في وقت آخر أذكرها والحمد لله رب العالمين.
Inshallah ta'ala, there's some more that remains of this, but we're going to stop right here. Preparation for Salat al-Isha, and we thank the Shaykh for what he put forth today in the two lectures, and you as well for your coming together. Again, we want to remind you.